Welcome to Tracy's channel.
Hey guys, so today we are out and about in Clashville. Exploring the place. She's crazy. And I will
I'm
miss
trying
her.
To show you everything.
Somya is going away. So I just wanted to share her experience in Abidjan because she's been here, is it 3 months?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so her 3 month experience so that we have different opinions so that it's not always mine because some of you think I'm always lying and I'm not. So let's do this. The first question is...
That's an interesting joke.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. Oh, is it on?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, great. Okay. My internship opportunity from Princeton is actually the one that brought me to Abidjan. Honestly, and this is something that I'm not very happy about, is that Abidjan or West Africa in general was never on my bucket list when I thought of visiting Africa as a continent. And since this is my first time, I was a little skeptical of what I'm going to really make out of my African experience by Abidjan being my first spot. But I'm so glad in so many ways that this has been the place where I landed, because I feel that Abidjan or West Africa is the best place for you to bust all these myths that you hear about the continent. In terms of its leisure places, what it has to offer, the culture, this is really the melting pot of all that you can find in different areas. So I thought my weekends would be really relaxed. I would mostly be at home. I didn't know if I would meet interesting people, but all of that has turned around. I think I've met so many interesting people, and not just in terms of acquaintances, but I'm going back with a lot of friends, a lot of memories, and just a longer bucket list than what I came with.
Wait, I should take a picture of your... I think I got it.
Get it?
This is very dramatic. There's a lot happening behind
me. Yeah.
So my favorite part about Abidjan is that when we think about inequality, we often think about what people do in their free time, what people think like, and what their priorities are. What I like about Abidjan is how so many things that can be perceived as high society, high class, inaccessible, are accessible to everybody. You have islands and beaches to go at a stone's throw. If you want to eat a meal, you don't have to think about a restaurant, but you can also choose which island you want to go and eat this meal on. And all of this comes at less than $20. I do realize that $20 is a lot compared to the purchasing power of the city. But still, it sort of gives everybody the access to what nature and what culture has to offer. And that for me is the highlight of Abidjan. What I really sort of dislike, and I push all of you to explore, and how Tracy best covers this in her vlog, is to go out of your comfort zone. You hear about all these things that people are unsafe, things are unsafe, the environment is unsafe, it's dirty, it's unhygienic. All these are your own biases. And the next time you think about it like that, stop and question what really is prompting you to think so, because the answer is going to be your own mental block. And if you succumb to it, then you are really missing out on all the beauty and the experiences that the city has to offer. So take the Woroworos, take the public transport, meet local people, hang out with people outside of your circle, go for these amazing meetups, all these cultural events that keep happening, French centers, talk in French, buy from local shops. If you're not experiencing this, you're not only just losing out on money, but losing out on a lot of beautiful memories. So salut! So I came in with zero knowledge of French, but I feel it's been so easy to navigate around. Because, and here I would dissect my answer in terms of two people. The locals, the taxi drivers, for example, the vegetable vendors, the fruit ladies, They have been my best friends and they have been my greatest French teachers. In fact, the security guard at my own office refuses to let me in and out without talking to him for one whole minute in French. So my quick tips to you, for if you don't know French at all, would be learn how to greet, learn how to say hello, learn how to say goodbye, and learn how to say how are you. So bonjour, ça va, and enchanté is going to take you a long, long, long way. These are the three magical words I would say in Abidjan. Second thing is that you will always need to keep asking prices about different things. So what I suggest is learn the numbers. Learn numbers from 1 to 10 and then learn numbers in multiples of 500. So 500, 1000, 1500. These are basic denominations that you will use in your everyday transactions the most. And it's very important to understand the price that they are telling you and also to ask how much is going to make them feel that you pretty much know all the French that you need to. To share a little anecdote, I once sat in a cab and I very confidently greeted the cab driver saying "Bonsoir, ça va?" under Combia for going to Kokodi, and he actually thought that I am French. The problem came when he started wanting to talk to me about different things. And I was just like, un peu français. And that's when he realized that I don't know French at all. But to all in all, the people are very, very receiving. Completely opposed to what the popular notion is. You come in with a negative attitude, you will feel that people are negatively perceiving. Where I did find a little bit of hostility is amongst the sort of high society French speakers here. So amongst the expat community, amongst the people who are seasoned French speakers and educated, they sort of tend to look down upon your French pronunciation in terms of your French vocabulary and try to boss you around and correct you in your pronunciation, which personally for me becomes a little discouraging. However, the locals, and that's the sort of people that I care about here, and they have been my best of friends. So yeah, just explore, go outside of your comfort zone and remember the five magical words.
Yay!